Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Wang. Here is the question. Which is greater? In the first question, we have two numbers to compare. The two numbers are square root of n to the power of square root of n plus 1 and square root of n plus 1 to the power of square root of n. If n is bigger than 8, in the second question, the two numbers are e to the power of pi and pi to the power of e. In general, how to solve this kind of question? In this video, we are going to introduce a general idea to solve this kind of question. First, we consider a special function, f of x equals log of x divided by x. X is bigger than 0. Here, log function is the natural log. We are going to prove this function is decreasing when x is bigger than or equal to e. How to prove? We are going to use the calculus method to consider the first order derivative of f of x, because the right-hand side is a fraction. Therefore, we can use the quotient rule to derive the first order derivative of f of x. The first order derivative of f of x equals the derivative of the numerator times the denominator minus the numerator times the derivative of the denominator divided by the denominator squared. The derivative of log of x equals 1 over x. The derivative of x equals 1. Simplify the numerator. We have 1 minus log of x, then divided by x squared. If x is bigger than or equal to e, we have log of x is bigger than or equal to 1. Therefore, this numerator is less than or equal to 0. Therefore, the first order derivative is less than or equal to 0 because x squared is always positive. If the first order derivative of x is less than or equal to 0, f of x is decreasing. If this condition is satisfied, which is x is bigger than or equal to e here. If we have two numbers, x and y, x is less than y, both x and y are bigger than or equal to e, then we have this result because this function f is decreasing. Therefore, f of x is bigger than f of y. By definition, f of x equals log of x divided by x. F of y equals log of y divided by y. Both sides times x times y. We keep the same direction of this inequality because both x and y are positive. Here, x and x are canceled out. Here, y and y are canceled out. Then we have y times log of x is bigger than x times log of y. Based on the property of log function, we can move y to the power position of x. Similarly, we can move x to the power position of y. Then we have x to the power of y is bigger than y to the power of x. In summary, if e is less than or equal to x, x is less than y, we have x to the power of y. It's bigger than y to the power of x. Now we are ready to apply this result to solve our questions. For the first question, we can replace x by square root of n. From the given condition, n is bigger than 8. Therefore, square root of n is bigger than square root of n, 8, which is bigger than e. Let y equals square root of n plus 1. Certainly, it is bigger than square root of n, which is x. Therefore, this condition is satisfied. Then we can use this result. Replace x by square root of n, y by square root of n plus 1. Square root of n to the power of square root of n plus 1, which is x to the power of y. Based on this result, which is bigger than y to the power of x, which is square root of n plus 1 to the power of square root of n. We have done the first question. For the second question, similarly, we define x equals e, which is bigger than or equal to e. Y equals pi, which is bigger than e. Certainly, y is bigger than x. This condition is satisfied. The only thing we need to do is to replace x by e, y by pi. Then we have this result here. E to the power of pi equals x to the power of y. Pi to the power of e equals y to the power of x. Therefore, e to the power of pi is bigger than pi to the power of e. We have done the second question. That's all. Thanks for watching and see you next time.